Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. I've got a little bit of a tinny, a little bit of a can, and it's one of them with the widget gadget thing inside, with the kind of nitrous and all that. I think it is anyway, pretty sure it is. I suppose it's fairly cheap, you know. I've got it in B&M Bargains, and it's Belhaven Best, which must be a bitter, I suppose, Best Bitter. And he's $4.49. I think they had it for cheaper than that. I think that's just recommended. I'm sure it was cheaper than that. I'm sure it was something like $3.99. But I could be wrong. I could be talking nonsense. Anyway, as you see, I've already tasted a few of them. But I'm going to give you one live. But I'm going to give you a review live. Not live, I do on Google Plus, but just straight out of the bag and see how we go. So let's pour that out. It's gonna, and all that. So it's gonna be a quick job. Wait. Whew. Little bit went on the sofa, but there you go. It's all right. Now, the way you pour these, you're supposed to pour it at 45. Years ago, when these first come out, you had to tip it upside down and pour it just above the surface and white cobblers. But now you pour it at 45 and you're supposed to end up with a perfect head. I think that it's climbing down the glass. I'm not sure how perfect an head it's going to be. Done exactly what it said on the thing. Well, it's getting there. What can I tell you about Belhaven? No, not really. I don't really know much about them. Ain't they? Yeah, Dunbar from East Lothian in Scotland. But weren't they owned by someone else? I'm not sure. Anyway, it's taking ages to get. It's creamy on the top, though. It's all lovely and creamy on the top. It says, warning, this can contains a pressurised insert. Do not tamper even when empty. You know what's going to happen. I'm going to cut that open and start stabbing you. I'll cut that. It's something naughty about me. It's like a little imp inside me. Imp inside me. And whenever you say, like them things like those red buttons at the bottom of escalators, don't press the red button. I have to be held back. Sweats come over me and everything. Straight jacket. Do not tamper even when empty. Beer brewed by the Belhaven Brewery, Dunbar, East Lothian, Scotland, H421PE. I'm just killing time while I'm waiting for this to settle a bit. I think that's settled as much as it's gonna, and I've got 14 inches of creamy head on it. 3.2 ABV. Yeah, I've got an idea. This probably was stronger. I'm not sure, but I've tasted it already, and it tastes a bit watery. But anyway, look, this a lot of these ones with the smooth and creamy head. A lot of them do, unfortunately. Right, it's not going to die anymore. So there's a big northern head on top of it. So perhaps that's how it's supposed to be. See, down south we go. Where's the rest of the bloody pint? They get an head like that, you go, whoa, hold on, you got room for a top in there? And they go, yeah, so top it up with beer. Isn't it? Right, so let's have a sniff. Ain't going to get nothing on the top of an head like this. Nothing off the top of the head. Right, let's let's see if I can put my snorkel on. Has anyone got a snorkel? I'm going to have to get a snorkel. Dive into one like this. I'm going to get a big load of it all over my nose and everything, so here we go. Good luck, everyone. Cheers. It tastes alright. It tastes kind of smooth. Let's just have another go. One more go. Having it from this angle. Yeah, getting little company notes, little bread notes and things like that. Excuse me. This messy in it. Right. Yeah, 14 inches of thing to dive through. You need a snorkel. So get yourself a snorkel if you're going to drink it. There's little company notes, little bread notes. There's a pithy bitterness. It's actually not too bad. But it's a bit... It's just a bit watery and a bit thin. I've got it all in my tash now. I'll just wring it out later. Yeah, it's a bit watery, a bit thin. You know, a bit kind of... It's not really doing anything. It's not really saying anything. It's not abusive or anything. It's not that I dislike it. And it's cheap enough, I suppose. But it's... You know, it's like... Kind of fairly low alcohol sort of sessioning beer. That if you had it cold enough, you could kind of fairly, you know, enjoy it a bit for the sensual side of it, because it is lovely and smooth to drink, but it's a bit bland. It's not really rocking or anything like that. I don't suppose it's supposed to be, but you know, it's like, you know, let's have another taste. Yeah, it's easy to swallow. And there are flavours in there, some nice flavours in there. You know. It's nice sort of malty orangey flavours. It tastes like a brew kit though, that's what it tastes like. But there's malty orangey flavours. But it tastes thin, it tastes watered down. It tastes like you've got a fairly decent beer that you've made a fairly strong home brew kit job and then watered it down and chucked something like nitrous, chucked it through a nitrousy thing, you know, kind of through one of these sparklers and that. A tight sparkler in it, and yeah. But there you go. Yeah, so what do you reckon? Bum 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 bum. Try it and let me know. Try it and let me know what you think. I'm mad on it. I'm mad. So good luck. See you in the next one. I'm gonna leave this on the side and have it a bit later. Maybe put it in the fridge or something like that. See you in the next one. Don't be late. Biddly biddly boo. Bye.